Yo, what's up guys, it's your boy K-Churai, and welcome back to another reaction video. Today we're going to be reacting to chapter 243 of Jujutsu Kaisen. In the last chapter, that boy Takaba was fighting Kenjaku, and it was going very well for Takaba, but I'm going to think that this chapter is going to go very poorly now for Takaba. So I'm not sure, we'll see. I hope he doesn't die. If he does, that would suck, but I think Kenjaku will probably win this chapter. But let's just jump into it, see what happens. Chapter 243, Bounce Off the Walls, Idiot Survivor. C1 finalist, the debut of a comedy duo from the past and present. Holy shit. Okay. Oh snap, they're pulling up to the stage now. Okay, so this is where I was last chapter. Good evening. How's everybody doing? Hey, you free Wednesday? You're asking now? We've already started, you know. As long as I'm not helping you move, I'm down. Never mind. Oh, wait, all you wanted from me was free manual labor? Damn. This dude Kenjaku is not a good homie. Dude, Toby over there is making a lot of noise. Welcome. Welcome. We're Pinch and Chance. Put us together and what do you get? Pinchin? Easy to remember, right? Oh my god. Well, dude, well, not exactly. I'm Takaba and you're Kenjaku. Anyway, it's nice to meet you all. Okay, alright. Hey, do you know the story of Momotaro? Hell no. Don't play dumb. Everybody's heard of this one. Didn't your parents tell the story when you were little? But I wasn't kidding. I've really never heard of it. Huh? I grew up with a single mother, and she never had time for me. Oh, I didn't know. Sorry to hear that. Seems I've hit a bit of a touchy subject. Oh my god. I don't know if you're one of those people that judge single-parent homes, but I grew up happy. My mom was always so kind and would read all kinds of stories to me. I remember one of our favorites was Momotaro. Wait, so you didn't know it? Why would you lie? I've always been so lonely. I just wanted some attention. My mom was always so busy. What a pain in the ass! You know, from the very beginning, you made the mood really hostile. Oh, is that so? I bet you've been real subtle, but I haven't forgotten about that from earlier. I don't know what you're talking about. What is your problem? I'm very mood sensitive, so I wanted to try to diffuse the tension by telling old stories that everybody knows. Well, excuse me for being an idiot and not knowing something. Isn't it just some story about a kid who wants to be friends with a dog, a monkey, and a peasant? No, 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 that doesn't even scratch the surface. Then I guess a moron like me just can't appreciate the literature. You think Momotaro is actually the biological son of the elderly couple in the story? I bet they ate those magic peaches to become young again before getting it on. That really came out of left field. But now that you mention it, that does sound plausible. Since I'm so dumb, I might just be talking out of my ass. Guess I gotta go get some first-hand experience. Time to do as Momotaro did and slay some demons. See ya, Grandma. Hey, give me a heads up that we're starting a skit next time. Momotaro, wait! Take these kibidango with you. Sauce, but you know I don't eat anything someone else has touched. LOL. Quit yapping. Just take them. Whoa, they look great. This is the kind of dongo that only those chilling on a great pension would have the free time to make. The only reason you're this goddamn free is because the younger generation is freaking is breaking their back supporting boomers. You know what? I'm glad I won't have to see your ugly mug for a while. You're the worst. Have a good life. You're the worst. Have a good life. At the end of the day, he's probably a good kid at heart. Language sure is strong with one. Have a good long life, bro. All the toxicity he spewed gets canceled out. Hey, it's a golden retriever. Where's your sense of reality? At least make it a Japanese dog, like a Shiba Inu or something. You know it's tasty when it's won a gold award. You mean like those awards that fried chicken joints are always winning? If anything, it's more rare to see a restaurant without one these days. Wait a sec, is it safe to feed Dongo to dogs? How are you, now you care about realism? I think we should hold off. Could have been cooked with onions. Agreed, there's no way to know for sure. Onions are poisonous to dogs after all. Interesting. There's a phone number on the collar. We're getting too real again. The world building is so off. Hello? Yeah. The golden retriever. That's right. Oh, so he's a Labrador. Why are you getting so buddy-buddy with the owner? They're living in the Nerima, about a 30-minute walk. Aren't we on a journey to slay the demons? Guess we got a flake. You think the demon's lair has their phone number on their site? Nice, they're on Yelp. Looks like we've completely stopped trying to keep the world consistent, huh? But hang on, check this. A shocking 2.1 stars. LMAO, or LMAO. You can't always trust reviews. Hello? We'd like to cancel our reservation, please. Yep, uh-huh. A cancellation fee? Oh, okay, then. In that case, we'll send the monkey and peasant on ahead. Wait, what? What? The monkey and the peasant are gonna get their asses beat. Didn't you even learn in school that you're not supposed to split your forces and send them in one by one? You're the one that doesn't get it. Haven't you heard of the air force supremacy? And just what exactly do you expect the peasant to do in the air? At most, it's all it is going to do is carpet bomb them with shit. The shit carpet bomb is the army's ultimate attack. That's some grade school logic right there. It seems we have a tough choice in front of us. Do we continue to worry John's owner? You named the dog? You named the dog. Or do we sacrifice the lives of the monkey and the peasant? I think it's pretty obvious we're supposed to choose their lives. First things first, we're gonna ice the peasant. What a twist, but why? Cause keeping an anxious pen owner worried feels very un-peasant. That's actually, honestly, that made it kind of worth it. But that was a lot of build up for one joke. Was this like, I feel like this was like the only real joke, honestly. What a zinger. That's got them laughing even up in the rafters. Hey, are you okay? Yeah. I'm just thinking it's about curtains. Uh-oh, the show's about to end on the show of my dreams. Up until now, you could probably say I wasn't even qualified to spell the word comedian. But up on the stage, even your fangirls are making me happy. What is this? Fan right. Take those stitches off. Are this supposed to, interesting. It's supposed to be like the girls that got off by Sukuna that were ghetto supporters. Interesting. I want to keep going. I don't want this to end. Don't cry. You'll spoil the mood, Pat. That's all, folks. Damn. So you're telling me Kenjaku packed this dude up? It was as expected. I already knew that Kenjaku was probably going to win, but I'm happy that they finished out Takuba's thing too, because that was cool. That's all, folks. Thanks. You know? Is he just going to kill him on the ground? You were hilarious up there. Oh, nice. He started laughing. This is nice. He actually got him a smile. Okay, so at least Takuba accomplished something. I'm not going to scroll all the way down in this next panel. I'm just going to take this in from what I have right here. I have a little sliver on my screen. But this dude, Yuta Akotsu, is here now. I wasn't even sure bro was in the picture. I thought he was going to be waiting to jump Sukuna, but apparently he's on team jump Kenjaku. Goddamn. This is jumping in its highest degree, I'm not going to lie. This, it has to be. He just got done 1v1ing. Okay, if we're really gonna talk about it, this dude Kenjaku just got done fighting one person, and then he finished him. Fought another person, then he finished him. He fought another person, and then he finished him. Or did he finish him? Nope, because Yuta Akotsu pulls up right before he can finish the job. As he was giving bro his flowers, he pulls up, stunned as fuck. He's like, oh shit, Yuta's here. Curse technique, reversal, anti-gravity. Slice? Oh shit, that bro got hit. He definitely got hit. Yuta's still standing too, so we're good. How? What's Ikotsu doing here? With his enormous amount of cursed energy, I should have noticed his every move. Did he get decapitated? Is he dead? I see. You didn't want anyone interrupting the show. Dude, talk about a fucking goat pulled through. Hell yeah, man. Flop, bro. Kenchaku is basically dead. Unless he can reverse curse technique straight down. Or, like, I don't know. I don't know what his plan's gonna be. Flop. This was your plan from the very beginning. Takuba-san doesn't kill people. I do, nigga. What you want from me, huh? God damn, that was hard as fuck. I'm not gonna lie. Holy shit. He said Takuba-san doesn't kill motherfuckers. So, after you guys got done with your little show, I had to finish some shit up with you. You understand that? So, that was the plan. I guess Takuba would go in there, get him to lower his guard, and then Yuta would jump in there. But how did Yuta get so close without Kenjaku knowing? Was it just because, would you call that a domain expansion, what they just went through? I think that you would call that a domain expansion. I feel like that's a domain expansion. I don't quote me on this, but I feel like that boy Takuba was definitely in a domain expansion. They just got out, and then boom, that's what happened. Or it could just be his fucking ability, which is insane, because what would his domain expansion be? Alright, anyways, makes sense. It's a shame to bow out before I finish. But my will be passed on. To who, nigga? You ain't got no supporters? I'm trying to think. I don't know what he's talking about. He doesn't have any, like, real supporters like that. Maybe Sukuna. And that's what he's talking about. My will be passed on. He thinks Sukuna's just gonna finish the job. Then I guess, but I don't know. I'm not sure if he can just... I don't think that's what he's talking about. I think he's got another ace up his sleeve. Maybe. We'll have to see. Alright, y'all. Let's end the chapter. Go to chapter this week. You know what I'm saying?
Okay, guys. If you enjoyed, make sure to leave a like for your boy. And to comment how you felt about the chapter below. I'm very curious if you guys think Kenjaku is dead.
I personally am signing up to the belief that he is going to die from this, and something maybe happened. I don't know, dude. I don't see him living past maybe two, maybe one chapter after this, and maybe we see how he might come back. I just don't know. I don't know what he means by that last part, but we'll have to see. And yeah, subscribe, and I'll see you guys next week for the chapter. Was there a break next week? Let me check. Break next week. No. Okay, so I'll see you guys next week. And sorry for this one being a little late. I know it's a couple days behind, but you know, some shout outs. Anyways, I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace. Deuces.